Hi, my name is Joseph Klein. I hear from you, from my friends, and thanks for your whole website. I take as much knowledge from you. I have a question. When I create my listing, and I put it in the search terms keywords, should I take from Google AdWords, like from one ASIN, and I take the whole thing and I put it inside how much I can, or I should take only the best one? Should take like three, four listings and take the best one from everyone, and then put in. And also, I see you told that when I make PPC and I make a campaign from a whole 800 keywords, and when I see I don't have impressions for one keyword, you said that it can be because I don't have it in the listing. If I have it in the search term, it is good. Please leave me back a message. Thank you.
Hey, Joseph, thank you so much for the question. And thanks for being a listener. And I'm so glad that you are taking action. So that's awesome. What I want to do here is talk a little bit about keywords and keyword ranking and all of that good stuff. Because the main reason that you are looking for keywords, and we'll talk about that real quick as far as like, you know, what's your first step for finding those keywords that you want to target? Because it sounds like you're, you know, pretty new, right, at this. And from here, you need a starting point. And we all kind of need a starting point to figure out what keywords we want to target. Now, the easiest way to do this is you're going to be looking at your competitors, right? We want to look at our competitors, okay, on the top, you know, or out of the top 10, let's say, or top 12, and we want to see the theme that's starting to run here. If we're going after garlic press or stainless steel garlic press, you're probably going to see that in everyone's listing. So that's like the very first thing that we want to pay attention to right now. That's going to be in our title, of course, because our title is going to be one of our main drivers for ranking, okay, because that's what is weighted the most as of right now. And then from there, we also want to look at the back end of our seller's account. I think that's what you're asking. Where do I find other keywords to put in the back end? And again, there's no really set way or set thing that I could advise you to do other than what I'm about to tell you, which is doing that, going to the Google Planner maybe, and then looking at your competitor's listing, okay? And I've done this before in other episodes, and I'll give you guys a few of the links that I've talked about ranking and some of the things to find keywords that you could possibly target, whether that's in your pay-per-click or just, you know, including them inside of your listing. So the one way is, yes, to go over to Google, take your competitor's listing, the actual URL, the web address, take that, go over to Google Planner, it's their keyword tool. You need an AdWords account for that. It's free. And then you just punch that in, and it's basically a website address that you're going to be scanning in a sense. And then what it's going to do is it's going to comb that listing and then go out and give you suggested keywords inside of Google. Now, this doesn't mean that these keywords are being used inside of Amazon, but it does give you a good idea of the market that's searching for this. So it's a good starting point, okay? Now, another thing that you can do is you can straight up just take that keyword, let's say stainless steel garlic press, use that as your root keyword, okay? And then you can run that search in the keyword planner and probably get more of that particular keyword, okay? Or around that keyword. That would be another thing. And then I would start to look at common themes that are starting to be searched for. And you may also even discover another product along this research, because a lot of times you're gonna see similarities in other keywords, all right? But that's for another discussion, okay? But that's one way. The other tool that's pretty cool to use is merchant words, okay? Now, guys, if you guys want any of the tools or anything that I use, or if you want to learn more about them, you can head over to my resources page, and I have these linked up over there, and that's theamazingseller.com/resources, and again, I'll throw these inside of the show notes to this episode. But merchant words, I don't look at that as like, you know, exactly like what's being searched for on Amazon. Like, I kind of take that, you know, for what it's worth. Like, it's aggregated different keyword searches that could be, you know, kind of like Google Planner type keywords, but it does give you other suggestions to try and test. All right. AmaSuite 4 has a keyword feature in there as well. And what they do is, let's say that you're going after garlic press, what it actually does is it will add another letter to the back end of that. So let's say it's garlic press space A, and then everything that would start with an A, including garlic press, so garlic press apparatus, let's call it, and that's not one, but let's just say it was, that would be in there, but it would give you everything that started with an A after garlic press, and then it would do that for the B's and the C's, and it would go all the way through the alphabet, and there's even, you can even do it through the numbers and all that stuff. So that would be, Amisuite would also do that and give you a ton of data. Now, another really cool tool is simple keyword tool, that is, and again, that's, I believe how it is, simple.keyword.com. Tool.com, I believe it is. But again, I've got that linked up in the show notes, and I've also got it linked up on my resources page. But what this one does, it allows you to take your competitors. Let's say you take your top three or top five competitors, and what you can do is take their ASIN, and then you can reverse search that. So then you can get all of the keywords that are being found inside of Amazon for their product. Okay. And then from there, you can take and again, find the common themes that you're finding or the top keywords that they're ranking for, and then start to target those. And yes, you will want to put the ones that are, you know, driving more traffic. And again, this is going to take some time to figure this out. But what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to take and put them in the back end, because I believe that it's the title and then it's the back end keywords. And then from there, it is, you know, like the bullets and then the title or the description. Those have very little. They do have relevancy factors when you do pay-per-click and stuff. But I believe that the main search places or the search, you know, I guess relevancy for search, organic search, that is your title. And then the back end would be the two main sources. Now, if you have variations, again, I'm going off on a little bit of a tangent here, but if you have variations, you can also fill in another five fields in the back end of each variation to then cast a wider net. So if you have a lot more keywords than you have room for, you can do that if you have more than one variation. Now, if you don't have more than one variation, you can't really do that, okay? But again, this is going to take time. This is going to take testing, but you will see the obvious ones. And the obvious ones, after you kind of go through this process, you're going to see the obvious ones. Those are going to be the ones you're going to want to target first. Now, the other thing that you will start to learn of once you start running pay-per-click, you mentioned running pay-per-click. You can do the same exact thing. Take all 800 keywords or 500 keywords that you get from these different search, you know, terms that you're bringing back or this certain research, you can take that and then plug that into an Amazon pay-per-click campaign, run some money, you know, or run some traffic towards it using, you know, a budget. And then from there, seeing what it does, look at the impressions, look at the clicks, look at the sales. Then it's going to tell you, you know, what keywords are getting the most traffic, which ones are getting the most clicks, and which ones are getting the most sales. And then you can start to say, okay, well, now I'm seeing that this is well searched for, but I'm paying for this. And right now, maybe I don't have enough reviews to convert, but I still want to show up for those. So instead of paying for them right now, I could take that data and then bring them into my listing so I can start organically ranking for those, okay, over time. Again, I just threw a ton at you, but that is how you do it. And again, this isn't something that's going to happen overnight. You're going to go ahead and want to start really just defining the market with all of these different searches that you may not even be aware of. And again, after you run your auto campaign in pay-per-click, you're going to start to discover what Amazon is feeling that you should be positioning your product in front of that type of a search. And then you can take that data, put it into more Amazon pay-per-click campaigns, and you can start to tweak your listing and optimize it fully. Okay. But again, this is something that doesn't just happen overnight. It takes time, and you also want to give it time to really run through the different tests if you're running tests. All right. I'm getting a little off now if I start going into testing. I don't want to do that yet right now. All right. But what I do want to say is you're on the right track. You definitely want to be pulling your competitors' search terms so you can get a good idea. Use Google. Use Google Trends too. I mean, Google Trends has related searches for that trend, and that might be another useful tool. Let's see, Merchant Words, I mentioned those, or that, you know, particular software. Amisuite 4 is another one. All of this stuff is great data to have, and then you can start refining your search. One little tip, as you're doing this, or actually before you do this, go to the simple keyword tool and run a reverse search on your listing and mark that and date it that particular time. So this way here, after a month, you can rerun that and then see how well your listing is starting to get organic search. okay? And then this way here, you can start to see the impact that you're making by doing all of this research and then plugging it into your listing. So just a really great way to see how well you're doing with the keyword, implementation of the optimization, all of that stuff. That's a lot of big words there. Optimization, implementation. I can't believe I can even say that. All right. So anyway, that was a pretty long-winded answer, but I needed to cover all that. So hopefully that makes sense. Again, full transcripts are now available for episodes. So you can go back and read what I just said if you'd like to. And again, the show notes are there for you as well. So if you guys want to submit a question, head over to theamazingseller.com/ask, and you can do that. I want to also, again, remind you guys, if you're brand new and this is your first time to the show, I want to welcome you. I love hanging out with you guys. This is just awesome to be able to virtually connect like this. And that's why I love the Ask Scott sessions. But if you are brand new and you're just getting your feet wet and you don't understand the entire process, the entire business model, I would recommend attending one of my live free workshops. This is where I break it down for you in five phases: how to pick a market and a product, how to source it, how to do a pre-launch, how to do a launch, how to promote the product, and everything in between. We go over that on a workshop, and we go through every single thing. We also do live Q&A. So if you want to attend one of them, I would love to invite you to the next one, and you can register for the next one by heading over to theamazingseller.com/workshop, and you can register there for an upcoming workshop. Well, hey there. Thank you so much for listening to that episode of Ask Scott. Now, that was just a highlight from one of our full episodes where I generally answer 3 to 4 questions on a podcast. If you want to go back and listen to all of the past archives of not just the Ask Scott session, but all of the full episodes where I do interviews with top Amazon sellers, people starting from scratch and building a business, if you want to listen to any of those episodes, head over to theamazingseller.com and you can find all of that over there. You can also find details there on how you can ask your own question and get it aired on an upcoming Ask Scott session and possibly see it here on YouTube or just on the podcast. All right, so definitely head over to theamazingseller.com. There's tons of resources over there for you to be able to build your e-commerce and Amazon business. So definitely go check that out. Now, I just wanted to remind you one thing before I let you go. There's a lot of information out there and some of it is really, really good. What I want you to remember is you have to not just consume the information, you have to actually apply that information. So take this information that you learned here today and apply it to your business. And this way here, you can get results. As my shirt says, I wear it almost daily. Take action. We'll see you guys.